We have the Philips PLM-100 computer. Control center. We use it. This is the source. This is basically if you just put your specimen on here and then you can control it. Start with the PL data collection. Open this screen. You save your whatever parameters you want to save, and then you can load them. These. You can move the. If you want it to load your sample, you can move this to load. Origin, move to origin, and then that'll move it back. To run your tests, you're going to set up the instrument. These are your setup screens. You just fill these in for the general, for the, you know, each individual one. Then you have your spatial, and you can set up your where it's sitting here. But right now, this is following this. So if I change this to move it, and then stage will move accordingly, and then move it to its where you set it. Okay, so that's your spatial, then you're filling these also. And then your spectral, fill in these, analysis method. Signal, so these, there is no second or third channel, and then your controls for your sampling. And then you say okay. Then you can just you can go to each individual one here too. Starting up. Okay. Then when you think you got it set up, then you can just hit your spectral setup here and it'll continually run spectral samples. If the doors are open, the interlock's not made, then it'll turn off the laser. And then you get your results here. And it'll just keep continually scanning it until you hit cancel. So when you think you have it set up right and you're getting good readings, then you can cancel that. And then you can run a single sample. Test, and then you, it stores your results. open this curved SP display. And then you can load up just did. You have your results there, and it gives you all these all this information, results. And then if you wanted to do a spectral or spatial, and this is going to run this spatial sample, and this is all going to be determined by your the grid size that you pick in your spatial setup. The finer your grid, the longer it takes. Automatically saves it, and then you can view your displays. Oh yeah, this is the grid where you you pick for the size of it, and then like I said, that was on 1 millimeter. So if you went down to 100 microns, it'd be a lot slower. And again, you have your displays and your results, and then there's the spatial and spectral. this. While it's running, it'll tell you down here how long it's going to take. -7.2 minutes, but it's essentially it's just like the results would be similar to the spatial. I'm just going to cancel this out. Your results for that, you can use the multiple map. This is one I did earlier. And you have all these results here. If you do the spectral test, you'll come up with all these spectral and spatial. You'll come up with all these different results, and then you can view each one. Or if, like I just did a minute ago, the multiple map shows them all at the same time. Or you can show them individually here, and then you can like this one is the peak wavelength. You know, the same that came up in the multiple one. And then there's this is the same one that we just opened up a minute ago. And you can see the display here. And you can also a range. And that's it.